Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Lovely to see you all this morning, folks, for our family service today. Hopefully, you all have an order of service or someone you can share with next to you there. Just to highlight some announcements for the week ahead. The Register of Vestry Persons opens today for the next three Sundays. So it's today and the following two. If you'd like to sign that, it entitles you to a vote at the Easter General Vestry meeting, which will be in April, and that will be announced again closer to the time. You have to be 18 years or over to sign the book as well. Now, if you've done it in the past, you don't need to do it again. So it is open today for anyone who would like to sign the register. Confirmation class continues tomorrow evening at 6:30 at the rectory for all our young people involved with that. Bible study continues 7:30 on Tuesday evening in the minor hall. And today, after our service, as we had announced last week, there will be tea and biscuits. If you can stay, do stay with us for a bit of fellowship after the service today. And we thank Elaine and William and their team for that, in resurrecting that today for the family services in the future each month. Also, if we have food on our mind, we also have a response in regards to that. You've all seen on the news over these last days the troubles out in Turkey with the huge earthquake and the sheer numbers of people that have been lost in that, and the many others yet to be found, and those who have been irreparably damaged within that too, never mind livelihoods and housing and all of that. The Church of Ireland's Bishop's Appeal has released £10,000 from its reserves to help with humanitarian aid in Turkey, and of course Syria as well is involved with this. The Bishop's Appeal is encouraging all parishes to respond by donating to that very fund. We're going to have a soup and bread lunch after our service on Sunday the 5th of March. Just to let you know, folks, we'll be announcing this each Sunday up to that point. Soup lunch on Sunday the 5th of March, where you can enjoy lunch together and donate to the Bishop's Appeal through that to go out to Turkey and Syria. Those folks who are unable to attend that day can also donate by using the envelopes, and there are Bishop's Appeal envelopes available for the next few Sundays. And if you can come to the lunch, please do sign the sheet of paper out in the porch. It'd be good just for numbers, folks, so that the ladies and gents involved in getting that off the ground will know just how much to supply, of course, if we can have an average of numbers. So do, if you can and would like to be there and hope to be there, sign the sheet out in the porch. Thank you very much. Now I'm going to hand over to Sam to lead our service.
We start our service this morning with a word of scripture from Matthew chapter 11. Jesus said, "Come to me, all who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest." The Lord be with you. Let us confess our sins to God our Father. Heavenly Father, Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault, by what we have done and by what we have failed to do. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen.
forgives all who truly repent. Have mercy on us, pardon and deliver us from all our sins. Confirm and strengthen us in all goodness, and keep us in eternal life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We stand to sing our first hymn, Standing on the Promises.
Psalm 136. Please respond where there is poll time. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is gracious. Give thanks to the God of gods. Give thanks to the Lord of lords, who alone does great wonders, who by wisdom made the heavens, who laid out the earth upon the waters, who made the great lights, the sun to rule the day, the moon and the stars to govern the night. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. We will now stand to sing some very well-known children's choruses, starting with He's Got the Whole World in His Hands, and then the B-I-B-L-E, That's the Book for Me.
Jane Dilley will now bring us our Bible reading.
The Bible reading is taken from Matthew chapter 6, beginning at verse 25. Therefore I tell you, do not worry about your life, what you will eat or what you will drink, or about your body, what you will wear. Is not life more than food, and the body more than clothing? Look at the birds of the air. They neither sow nor reap nor gather into barns, and yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not of more value than they? And can any of you, by worrying, add a single hour to your span of life? And why do you worry about clothing? Consider the lilies of the fields, how they grow. They neither toil nor spin. Yet I tell you, even Solomon in all his glory was not clothed like one of these. But if God so clothes the grass of the field, which is alive today and tomorrow, is thrown into the oven, will he not much more clothe you, you of little faith? Therefore, do not worry, saying, what shall we eat, or what shall we drink, or what shall we wear? For it is the Gentiles who strive for all these things. And indeed your heavenly Father knows that you need all these things. But strive first for the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well. So do not worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow will bring worries of its own. Today's trouble is enough for today. Here ends the reading.
Thank you, Mary Jane, for our reading today. Let us stand to sing Beneath the Cross of Jesus.
Seated. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, we do thank you for your presence with us this morning, and we ask now, as we look at your word, that you will speak to us afresh through it, and may our hearts and minds be open to you, and to hear your still small voice speaking. And Lord, help us to draw closer to you, and we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. Yes, Mary Jane, thank you very much again for that reading. That's a reading that we're going to draw out a little something this morning. It is a family service, so hopefully the talk will be geared to both young and old alike. First of all, I'm going to ask Chris to throw up our first slide, if that's okay, Chris. Okay. What is that, folks? Where do you see the like of that normally? What is it? Yes, Oliver, yes. It's an emoji. An emoji. And it's a sad face, isn't it? A sad looking. And in emojis, if you have a phone, folks, at all, you'll find dozens of these things in it. And if you have a really up-to-date phone, iPhone, whatever it is now, I don't know, maybe 510 or something, but you'll find all these emojis in it. And there's nearly one for every single thing in life, every circumstance and everything that'll happen. But this one is sad-looking, but it actually is an emoji of worry. He's worried. Okay. And that is our word today. We're going to look at worry. Anybody worried in church today? I'm sure we all carry different worries. And they come and go, don't they, in our lives? Sometimes we can get around them quite easily. They'll pass. But other worries seem to linger for a long time. And we find it very difficult to cope with them sometimes. And they can get on top of us. And we're human beings. And so we all have our troubles and worries. Now, I'm going to ask Matthew to join me on stage for a few moments. Matthew is aware of this happening. He is my prop today. So he is. I'm looking for a balloon pump, and he is the best balloon pump I know. He's a live human balloon pump. Now, is everybody okay with balloons in church? All right, folks. The only thing, a disclaimer I'm going to throw out now, is there's going to be a pop at some stage. So anybody of a nervous disposition, you are very free to pop out for a couple of moments, but seriously, I'll just let you know there will be a pop of the balloon, and there are mics up around here, so the sound will be kind of a little bit amplified with that. Okay. Now, he's not going to blow it up all at once. Okay, he's going to blow up gradually. And what I'll be doing is watching your faces. Because what I've seen before of people blowing up balloons, there is this kind of, oh, when's it going to blow? This kind of, and your face gets a bit crinkly looking, and your eyes start to screw up, and you're just waiting for that exact second when she's going to pop. And you look very worried when it is on its way to popping. So I'm going to be watching the faces at that time. So it is about worry this morning, folks, okay? Corban, are you okay with balloons, guys? All right, because Matthew's very close to you now, okay? You will hear it first, really, up here. If you like to plug your ears at any stage, you're more than welcome as well along the way. Matthew, I'll let you come out to my side, to me and Grace, if that's okay there, so everybody can see you there. I'll get you the balloon in hand there. So, Matthew, if you want to blow it for a bit there, okay. Maybe hold it there. All right. So there, it's underway. Would you say it's near popping yet, folks? No. So you're all very sedated and very relaxed at the moment. Okay, we're getting nowhere near the popping. Now, what I'm trying to show here with this, as the balloon gets bigger, sometimes our worries do. Worries in our lives, sometimes they start off small, and then they get bigger and bigger and bigger. Now, in the reading today that Mary Jane brought to us, you'll find there are certain things that we may worry about. Jesus is talking about them here on the Sermon on the Mount from Matthew 6, and he draws out certain things that you and I may worry about on a day-to-day basis. These aren't things that are wants, these are needs. Things that you and I need every day. I'm going to ask Chris to throw up a couple of more slides now. Wow. Anybody looking forward to dinner later on? Why do I always throw food up? I don't know why it's on slides there. But this is a lovely plate of steak and chips. Anybody like steak and chips? Yeah. Okay. And we'll also remind ourselves of two of the vegetarian folks as well. Hope you're looking forward to a good dinner too. Okay. Not everybody likes steak or eats it. Okay. There's a curry. Anybody up for curry? Yeah. Some people like a good curry there. That certainly keeps your eyes open after you have one of those. Okay. Or Chris, another one. Boys and girls, ice cream and jelly. Anybody like ice cream and jelly? Yeah, and adults too. Why not? A bit of ice cream and jelly after your dinner. Now, food is a need. You and I will not live long without food, so it's a need. And there are worries in life. Will we get enough to provide for our families or even for ourselves? And sometimes we go out into life and we think, okay, I've got to slave another week just to get a wage, just to get bread on the table. And in this current crisis of the cost of living, you can see that is very much something that's real. Something you and I may take for granted, dinner on our table, it becomes a real need for others who worry about it, who worry simply about getting food each day. We think of people who are homeless. We think of the starving in the world. And this is something that they need every day too. And sometimes they don't get it. So it's a real worry. And Jesus is right to highlight it here in the Sermon on the Mount, that a worry about food each day. So Matthew, I'll get you to blow a bit further. Ho-ho. I'll chance it just a bit more yet there. Okay, anybody think it's near popping yet? No, a bit more to go yet. Okay, well, it's up a bit further. And now I'm going to ask Chris to throw up another wee set of slides. Okay, first of all, who's that? Anybody know who that is? Guys, Mita, I think you said it there. It's Roger Federer. Roger Federer. Yes, probably one of the greatest tennis men in history, really, by this stage, the amount of wins he's had. But do you know something else about him? Last year, he was voted the world's best-dressed man. So there you go. I don't know if that cuts it or not, but he's known to be the world's best-dressed man. And with Roger, of course, he can afford it. He's got the money to dress in the stuff that makes you look good. Okay, next one, please, Chris. Who's that? Ah, definitely very quick on that one, folks. That is Michelle Obama, of course. Michelle was voted last year's best-dressed lady in the world. And again, yep, she might have a wee bit of money, a bit of clout. She can afford it to look very well. And then, Chris, another one. Okay, now, this one might throw you a little bit more, folks. Anybody know what that is, apart from being a handbag, like? It's a certain brand of handbag. You're starting to shout out the handbag labels, ladies. Sorry, Elaine. No, good guess, Elaine, good guess. It's not that now, no. And gents, I'd be worried if you're carrying one of these around. Okay. Ladies, do you know? Anybody? No, not that Yvonne, no. Absolutely. No, this is called a Hermes Birkin bag. You may have heard of it, ladies. A Hermes Birkin bag. Some of these are fetching £445,000 a bag. And one was sold at Sotheby's not so long ago for $2 million. Diamond encrusted thing. So I always say the old plastic bag out of the shop does as good as any. It holds it, that's all you need. This is a seriously, seriously valuable bag. Now folks, what we're looking at here in these last three slides is something of extreme value. Okay, Michelle and Roger, best dressed people in the world because they can afford it, put the stuff on. And maybe could afford one of these bags too if they needed it. You see, we need clothing to cover our backs, don't we? It's another worry in life that some people have. Can I buy my children clothes? Can I buy my children a school uniform? Can I buy the latest because their friends are wearing it? Or do I struggle? Can I buy a new pair of shoes for myself? The current pair wearing out. Whatever it might be, folks. Another thing that Jesus looks at. Food you need on the table. Clothing you need on your back. They're both needs. And many people worry about getting them. And you know, at the beginning of the passage, the word therefore is used. You see it there in the passage. Therefore, I tell you. Therefore is a linking word used a lot in Bible passages from what has gone before. And in there, Jesus has told the world, you cannot serve God and money. But you need enough money to get by. But when it becomes your God, you're in trouble. And people strive sometimes to want more and more money. And you fall into the traps of greed. And it's not need anymore, it becomes greed. People worry about money every day in their lives. And it is a struggle for many, again, to help us with our food and our clothes and our needs. But also, we don't serve it. We serve God because God provides. This is what Jesus is trying to say through the passage. We have our worries about food, clothing, shelter, water, all the stuff we need each day. Enough money to get by without falling into the trap of greed and wanting more. Jesus says, do not worry about such things. I will provide. Provided you walk with me and trust in me, I will provide. Now I'm going to ask Matthew to keep going. I'll step to your right a little more, Matthew, just for the moment there. So you keep going, Matthew. Are you ready for this, everybody? It's not going to go now. Not going to go, Matthew. No, any air left? No. Just when you don't want it to go, rather. He tried this in the house earlier, and it popped in no time at all. Have we anything sharp? Anything sharp, folks? There you go. Thanks, Colin. Matthew, I'll let you do that too. Thank you very much. Good teamwork there. Thanks, Matthew. I'll let you sit down again. We'll give him a round of applause, folks. Thank you very much, Matthew. And I thank you, Colin, for the sharp implement there as well. Thank you very much indeed. I say everything else, folks, don't work with animals, and obviously in this case, balloons as well, won't do as you want them to do. Thank you, Matthew. Folks, worries can get so much on our plate that they'll actually explode one day and we just simply go mad over the worry of them. So many worries can get on top of us and will actually cause us harm in the long term. And Jesus is telling us here in this passage, don't worry about what you'll eat or what you drink or what you wear. Everybody else does that. But your Father knows that you need all these things. He will look out for you. Strive first for the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well. It's a wonderful, wonderful verse. Probably the one we'd recognize the most in that passage. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things shall be added to you. Other things Jesus uses in the passage, and Chris is going to throw them up again for slides. Grass. Grass of the ground. It has no worry. It gets all the needs it does need. Water, sun, soil. Particularly in this land, it's always green. Grass doesn't worry, and yet God provides for it in every way. And we, in the passage, are much more important than grass. If He looks after the grass, He will look after us. And again, Chris, thanks. Flowers, or lilies, as it's described specifically in the passage, the lilies of the field, look how they grow. They don't work. And yet, Solomon, in all his glory, wasn't clothed like one of these. They're the beauty of a flower. We can't create them. But nature, under God, brings them together in the beauty that they are. They don't worry. And yet, they're looked after in every way. And finally, Chris, the last slide. Birds. A lot of birds there around the feeding table. And it says in the passage too, the birds of the air, and God looks after them too. Your Heavenly Father feeds them, and yet they don't gather and bring into barns. They don't worry, but they always get enough to do. God provides for them. So folks, when we worry, and it is natural that we do, and they'll come and go in our lives. That's the way we're built. But if we trust in Christ, follow Him, and offer Him our worries every day, He wants to hear them from us. He knows about them anyway, but He wants to hear about them from us in prayer. He will lift them, carry us through them, provide for us in His way through them. So when we worry, folks, hand them over to Jesus, and He will lift them and strengthen us through them. Don't worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow will bring enough worries of its own. That's so true. Every day has enough trouble for itself. Don't look too far ahead. Trust in the Lord daily. Let Him provide and strengthen us in our faith, particularly in times of worry. Let Him put His hand in ours as He carries us through. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, we do thank You that You are with us through thick and thin in life. And we are human beings and we're prone to worry, some of us more than others. Lord, help us when those worries come, whatever they may be, that we can hand them over to You. Take that weight off our shoulders and off our minds and off our bodies, that You can strengthen us because You want to lift us through these things. And Lord, You command us and challenge us to seek first Your kingdom and its righteousness, and then these things will be added to us, that they will come out of Your hand. And help us to remember those who worry for needs every day, such as food and clothing. Out of the abundance that You give us, Lord, above what we even need, help us to give to others who worry for those needs. And Lord, help us indeed to live in the day, each day at a time, for each day brings enough trouble of its own. And may we sense Your strength and Your guidance and Your love always, in worry and in happiness. And we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. Folks, Corban are coming to sing us a song in a moment, but first of all, this being family service, we're going to sing Happy Birthday to all who have a birthday in February. Anybody in church got a February birthday? Now, I know two immediately comes to mind. Anybody got, Elizabeth, yes. Anybody else, February birthday, or owning up to it? A February birthday. Okay. See a few folks getting pointed out there as well. Anybody in Corban? Any February birthdays? Okay, folks, yeah. Okay. Well, going to get Lauren to play us a verse of Happy Birthday, and we'll sing it. And the line is Happy Birthday to everyone. Okay, when it comes to that. Thanks, Lauren. Remain seated, folks. Corban's going to sing us Living Prayer. Thank you.
Loving Father, we pray for the whole family of the Church. Remind us that in Christ we are one body, with many members, and each member belongs to one another. Help us remember that we each have individual gifts and ministries, according to your grace. Show us how to spread your message of love through acts of service and kindness to meet the needs of those around us until you are coming again. We also pray for all who serve within our parish, especially for our rector, the readers, the wardens. Give them the spirit of willing service and true humility. Grant that they may lead your people in the way of Christ. We thank you for those who provide music, those who lead our youth organizations, and for all who attend our worship and parish organizations. In this family service, we pray especially for our young people. Coping with the influences and demands of school, university, or work, may they know real love and security in their lives. Lord, in your mercy. Father, we ask you to be with all those in Turkey and northern Syria, following the earthquake that has devastated hundreds of lives. We give thanks for the aid that is being given, and for the promises of help that have been made by many nations. Comfort, we pray, those who are trapped in collapsed buildings, those who have lost loved ones, those who wait for news, and those digging through rubble to save others. We also keep in our hearts those in Ukraine. We pray for peace and for the laying down of weapons, and for all those who fear for tomorrow, that your spirit of comfort would draw near to them. Lord, in your mercy. Almighty God, we pray especially for King Charles and the members of the royal family, for our government and those in authority. May they lead through humility and love, leading us to peace and unity. Lord, keep our leaders grounded in what is good and true, protecting them from temptations and distractions of power and influence. May they know and follow you, leading through faith, ever working for the good of the people they serve. Lord, in your mercy. Creator God, thank you for our world and the places where we live. Help us all to be mindful that we are all created equal in your sight, and accept our deep regret that despite this, there is still so much inequality to be resolved. Help us to remember that you want us to be good stewards of your creation, living responsibly in the lands and seas of the earth. May all future growth be sustainable, and may we ensure that its abundance is fairly shared for the good of all. Lord, in your mercy. Lord, we pray for those who are sick or awaiting test results. Thank you for the doctors and nurses who care for them, and for those who are cared for at home. For those in our own parish unable to make church because of illness, we pray for them to be aware of your loving arms around them, holding them close. Lord, in your mercy. Loving God, we pray for all who bear the burdens of pain, bereavement, worry, and depression. We pray that they may have an awareness of your presence and an understanding that you are bearing those burdens with them and always working towards their healing and wholeness. Comfort all bereaved families, surround them with your love, and protect them from all harm. Loving God, you are merciful and forgiving. Grant that those who are suffering the hurts of the past may experience your generous love. Heal their memories, comfort them, and send them all from here renewed and hopeful. When our worries begin to spiral out of control, help us turn them into a conversation with you, confident that you will give us hope for the future. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of our Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. We continue in prayer with the Lord's Prayer. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Let us now join together in singing What a Wonderful Change.
Oh,
we sing the doxology. We will sing through this twice.
For the blessing again, if you can stay for tea and Vicky's after the service, you're very welcome to do that. If not, I'll see you at the door. Let's pray together. May the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep our hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with us this day and forevermore. Amen. God bless.